Hi guys, welcome to the fourth episode recap of Hometown Chachacha. As the episode starts, we see Hye-jin and Du-sik running into each other every morning, as they head off to their workplaces. One morning as Hye-jin heads for work, Min-sun and sister to wait, and to her surprise the sleepy Min-sun gets dressed in 3 minutes. To Hye-jin's disappointment, Du-sik doesn't show up that morning. So she suggests to order jjajangmyeon for lunch hoping Du-sik would deliver it. But he doesn't show up and Min-sun notes her being gloomy. In a magazine, Min-sun shows Hye-jin an article about a famous producer named Seon-ho. It seems Hye-jin is friends with the producer, and even had a crush on him, which she denies very strongly. They get a new patient to the clinic. As Hye-jin explains to him about his teeth, the man keeps on staring at Hye-jin. He asks why she hasn't installed any CCTV cameras in the examination room. Hye-jin explains to him, for that she needs the patient's consent, which she hasn't received yet. He also remarks about Hye-jin's beauty, which Hye-jin accepts cheerfully. When he makes his payment, he awkwardly touches Min-sun's hand, and Min-sun finds it uncomfortable. Ha-jung stops by Yoon-kung's store to buy some apples for her mother's death anniversary. As they talk, Yoon-kung reveals that they are expecting another daughter, and her husband is excitedly hopeful that they'll be able to raise their second child less tomboyish than Bora. They spot Bora and Ai-jun playing on the streets. When Ha-jung brings up about Ai-jun's tooth, Yoon-kung slips an apple to Ha-jung's bag as an apology. As Hye-jin and Min-sun head home, they run into Nam-suk. Nam-suk invite them to the shopkeeper's meeting. On noting Hye-jin is not interested, Min-sun tries to make an excuse. But when Hye-jin hears that Du-sik is the treasurer, she immediately agrees to attend. In the meeting, Nam-suk reveals that not many attend the meeting anymore, and tells Hye-jin to make a suggestion to bring everyone back. So Hye-jin suggests to make a members directory that include their contact numbers. As she explained the need, Du-sik comes with the members directory retorting at her for the lame suggestion. Ha-jung and Young-guk talks about work as they walk along the street. It seems Young-guk does remember Ha-jung's mother's death anniversary, but turns the conversation back into work when she hopefully waits for the conversation. Back in the cafe, Nam-suk and others talk about Ha-jung's divorce, but Hye-jin cuts in saying they are so old-fashioned, since she sees nothing wrong with getting a divorce, since it's just a choice they made, just like getting married. To her surprise, Du-sik also agrees with her. But Nam-suk clarifies that she's not judging them for being divorced, but only that there didn't seem to be any reason for it. Ha-jung and Young-guk walks in as they talk about them, and Nam-suk almost choke on her food. Hye-jin clearly doesn't seem to enjoy the gathering. She goes off to use the bathroom. Du-ri overhears Hye-jin nagging about everyone being so noisy, and kicks open one off the door, and scare her off by yanking a paper towel. Hye-jin finds Du-ri looking through photo cards of her favorite boy band. Hye-jin recognizes one of the members, and tells to Du-ri that she once treated him. But Du-ri of course doesn't believe her, even when she say that she took a photo with him. Disappointed, Hye-jin returns to the meeting. She notes Du-sik missing. Nobody gives her much attention, so she acts drunk and falls asleep on the table. Others suggest to take Hye-jin home, which is exactly what Hye-jin wanted. But Du-sik shows up on stage and starts to sing. Even though Hye-jin wants to see him singing, she just can't because she can't drop her act. Du-sik notes that she's faking it. To her disappointment, nobody wakes her up and she ends up sleeping on the table until the very end of the meeting. Everyone leaves as Du-sik assures them that he'll take Hye-jin home. As he piggyback her home, one of her shoes fall off. Hye-jin struggles on leaving the shoe behind and acting as drunk. So Du-sik calls and asks her to drop the act and get her shoe, since he knows she's just pretending. So she gets off from his back and goes to get her shoe. He retorted her for pretending to be drunk, so she confessed that is because she wanted to go home quickly. As Ha-jung heads home, she notes Young-guk following her. They get into a bit of an argument, and Young-guk hands her the kimchi container and mutter he enjoyed the kimchi. At home, when she opens the container, she's pleased to find a real cake inside it. Hye-jin looks through her stuff for the photo she had with Jun, the member of Du-ri's favorite boy band. After finding it, she climbs onto the bed and listens to the song Du-sik sang at the cafe. The next morning, Hye-jin hurries into the shop searching for Du-ri. But Du-ri has gone off to school. Disappointed, Hye-jin places an order and asks Du-sik if he could deliver it. When Du-sik mentioned the delivery fee, Hye-jin cancels the order and walks out. In the clinic, Hye-jin treats Gari, and as she leaves, the male patient from the other day returns. Gari notes the guy and wonders where she saw him. Hye-jin leaves him in Min-sun's care and leaves to the front desk. Du-sik arrives with the order she cancelled. He didn't charge for the delivery, claiming he stopped by because no one was at the cafe. Ha-jung and Ai-jun prepares for her mother's memorial service. When Ai-jun questioned her about placing roll cake on the altar, Ha-jung reveals that roll cake was her mother's favorite. That evening, Hye-jin rushes to the cafe to see Du-ri. When Du-sik complains about seeing her too much for the day, so Hye-jin clarifies she's here to see Du-ri, and shows her the picture. Du-ri screams in joy, and even decides to become friends with Hye-jin. Du-ri asks her a load of questions, and Hye-jin happily answers them, and even becomes a fangirl herself. When Du-sik remarks that Jun is not so much handsome, both Du-ri and Hye-jin angrily chase him away. next day is Doo-sik's day off, and he ignores all the calls. As he carries a surfboard, he runs into Nam-suk and Gum-chul, who begs him to work for them. But Doo-sik flat out rejects and leaves as they cry. As Young-guk heads for lunch, he runs into Yoo-chul-hee. Nam-suk and Yoon-kun watch them from afar, and Nam-suk tells to Yoon-kun that Yoo-hee was Young-guk's first love. She rushed to find Ha-jeom to tell her of the news, but learns that she has head back home. In the clinic, Hye-jin finds Min-sun unhappy. As Hye-jin tries to get her to talk, the male patient arrives again. She leaves the patient again in Min-sun's care. After the mold is removed, the patient claims that he feels residue in his mouth, and insists Min-sun to take a look. Hye-jin arrives just in time to see the man's hands on Min-sun, and chase him out of the examination room. Gari sees the commotion and hurriedly exits the clinic. Hye-jin tells Min-sun to call the police, but before them, the man himself calls the police, and reports that he's being falsely accused for sexual harassment. The officer readily takes the man's sides, and hurried off to the clinic. On hearing this, Yoon-chul follows after him. Back in the clinic, the patient brags about his wealth, and messing with him won't end well for them. Min-sun tries to calm Hye-jin, and tries to convince her to let it go, but Hye-jin is dead focused on getting the man behind bars. When the man insults Min-sun, Hye-jin loses it and kicks him on the face. When he gets back at her, Hye-jin acts fast and slaps him. Doo-sik rushes in his wetsuit, and knocks the man unconscious. After making sure Hye-jin is fine, Doo-sik collapses onto the unconscious man, and Hye-jin collapses as well. Police arrive to find everyone on the ground. In the hospital, the man reveals that he has no plans to settle with Hye-jin and Min-sun, and would sue them for assault. Yoon-chul tells him that the police is investigating the case, and as for now he's accused for sexual harassment. The man points out that they have no evidence against him, and decides to call his lawyer. But he realizes his phone is missing, and we see it in the dental clinic. In the meantime, we see Hye-jin and Doo-sik look up. No one gives any attention when Hye-jin complains about them taking to jail while the real culprit is on the loose. To her disappointment, Doo-sik is comfortable in the cell. When he tells to the officer that the wetsuit is uncomfortable, the officer takes him out of the cell, and offers him his own cloths, as Hye-jin watched them surprisingly. Yoon-chul returns from the hospital with the news that the patient is completely fine and faking, so both Doo-sik and Hye-jin can be released. On hearing that the man will be arrested after being discharged from the hospital, Hye-jin refused to leave the cell. Worriedly, Min-sun arrives to the police. The two get emotional on seeing each other, and sobs as they hug through the bars. As they cry, Doo-sik tries to point out that the door is open. Gari arrives and hands the patient's phone that she found in the dental clinic to Doo-sik. Doo-sik then visits the man in the hospital, and acts friendly and dumb with him. The man treats him like an idiot until Doo-sik shows him his phone. When he tries to grab it, Doo-sik pins him to the floor, and vows to get him punished for what he did. We then see the man being arrested by the police. Joo-hee stops by the town hall to register her move. Young-guk personally directs her through the process. Meanwhile, Nam-suk runs to Ha-jeong, and deliver the news of Joo-hee and Young-guk. Young-guk on the other hand notes that Joo-hee is still single. As he mentions her, that he is divorced, Ha-young rush into the town hall. The two women greet each other as Young-guk stands awkwardly. Ha-jeong returns home, and takes out all the containers from the bag she's been carrying, and stuff them into the refrigerator. Apparently she has intended to give them to Young-guk. At the clinic, Min-sun asks Hye-jin what she'd like for lunch, since she's heading out. After saying what she wants, Hye-jin tells her that Min-sun is her only friend, and that friends should protect each other. On her way back, Min-sun runs into Yoon-chul. He awkwardly hands her his business card and tells her to call him whenever she needs help. He advises her not to endure things on her own, if something ever happens in the future. Hye-jin receives a text from Doo-sik, saying that the man has admitted to his crimes, and will be investigated. She realizes that she never properly thanked him for his help. Hye-jin stops by Doo-sik's house with a bottle of wine in a fruit basket. As she wonders if to leave the wine or have it for herself, Doo-sik arrives scaring her off. At his house, Hye-jin notes the photo of Doo-sik and his grandfather. As they talk, Doo-sik tells her that he has no family and has been living alone, since his grandfather passed away. Hye-jin then tries to educate Doo-sik about wine, and how to properly drink it. But he surprised her with his knowledge, and even ends up educating Hye-jin on how to drink it. Seong-han and Jun arrives to Chun-jae's coffee shop. Chun-jae makes Juri serve them. She noticed Jun, but says to herself that he's a fake and can't be the real Jun, which Jun overhears. Meanwhile, Hye-jin allows Doo-sik to ask one question that he's curious about. So he asks her why she came to Gongjin, but adds that she doesn't have to answer if she don't want to. Hye-jin admits that the day she first came to Gongjin was her mother's birthday, and the last trip she had with her mother is the trip to Gongjin. She gets emotional when she talks about her. Hye-jin quickly hides her tears by saying she's feeling hot and asks Doo-sik if her face is red. He takes his hands, which had been clutching the ice bucket, and cups her cheeks. With that, the episode ends. In the epilogue, we see Doo-sik receiving a call from Gari on his day off. She tells him of the commotion at the dental clinic. As Nam-suk, Gum-chul and Ha-jeong complains about Doo-sik refusing to work on his day off, Doo-sik runs past them to their surprise. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please consider to like, subscribe, comment and share this video, since it'll help my channel grow so much. I hope to see you again in another video.